So learn Python by such a way. So why we are learning Python? And I'm also, whenever I am teaching, I also learning, because the Python is such a good language. It can be programmed at many places, any places, anywhere. Not C. C, you need a compiler, you need a machine. You cannot work on C in your mobile. You cannot run a C program to make an app. Not at all. So C is a kind of assembly language, I have told. And also Java. You cannot make a programming in Java in your mobile and do an app. It's difficult. I am not saying it. But Python, you can work at any place, anywhere. That is the reason. And it's open source. And it runs on anywhere. That is the reason. With the game development and all these things, we are issuing the Python. This man is a great. Whenever he is doing undergraduate like you, maybe at the year of second year, Van der Assen. Guido Van der Assen has developed this Python language in 1990. I have told you, take this man. He still looks after the language solidity. He was with Google and all, Dropbox and all these things. This is the person, and it is older than Java, and now it is becoming more and more popular. So these things you already know. I am not much. These things I little bit I am elaborating. This is great thing. This is same as a Java, like is a Python virtual machine. This because why the virtual machine concept has come? Because there are so many hardwares nowadays. You have a desktop PC. Desktop PC comes with Intel or AMD, or you have a mobile. You have there is a Sublix chip, maybe Apple A10 or MediaTek or Snapdragon. Lots of chips and everything. So one basic thing is there. The chips are maintained, because on a mobile phone you cannot afford a fan and all these things, but on your desktop you can afford a big fan, in your laptop also you can afford a fan and all these things. So your chip design is different, and whenever chip power is different and the chips are different, but so dissimilarities in hardware. So you have to make a combined one. Say Windows doesn't run on your mobile. Same way, that is one great way of unification is Linux. Linux runs in everywhere. But the Linux on your mobile, we take it as a granted as Android. Okay, so Android, that way 99% in India runs on Android, mobile phone. Desktop also you can run on Linux. But Linux is OS. It is the operating system. So there is you need a programming framework. Android is another kind of, I have to, another ways, that is like Linux, is a particular Linux version on mobile. So you can say Android app, you have to learn a lot of Java programming and all this. But the Python one good advantage is you can do programming on your host machine, on any kind of machine, or maybe Google, everywhere. That is the thing. And that the main idea behind this is Python virtual machine. You might say Java virtual machine is the same thing, but remember Python comes earlier than Java, at least 1 year earlier. So it is totally great idea by Guido Van der Assen, this Python virtual machine, because you can create the Python virtual machine on any machine. And remember, this Python virtual machine is developed by C++. So you cannot escape C++. So definitely it is not C alone, it is a C++. That is it. So that is a bytecode. It can run on any Python virtual machine. Same is here. It's a Python virtual machine. This is the script. You all already know this is all Python code should be .py. It should be signature. What things bytecode, it can be run on anywhere. So that is great. And one of the great advantages of Python virtual machine or Java virtual machine is it load balancing. Because if there is a huge load, say now a particular, say Aadhaar related, say vaccine related operation and all these things, immediately you have to have a lot of loads that coming. So then the virtual machine can help, so that you can hire the actual machine from the, say, Amazon, and you can run virtual machines there. So that is demand based, elastic based, that kind of elastic computability that you know in your cloud computing. Probably you know, you do some courses, cloud computing, it runs on this elastic computation facility. So, and the advantage of this virtual machine is that machine never hangs. If the machine hangs, another copy can be run on. So there may be two images running side by side in two physical hard machines, like you never see hardly any time your Google fails or Flipkart fails or Amazon fails, because the same program running on another hardware. So if one dies down, another is there. So that is the great thing about the virtual machine. Some question might ask about the how the faster is and all these things. Right now it is like my mobile internet speed is 150 megabits per second. Probably use also some Jio 150 megabits per second. Now one GPS is coming, is very free, almost only maybe 2000 rupees per month. One GPS, maybe it will be day by day slower. So computation will be also cheap. So most of the work will be have a remote desktop and all these things. You do not need a very high-end desktop. You can work on it on a remote desktop at Google or Kaggle, and you need a good display and a good speed, command speed, because we all know probably we do not carry now the pen drive on our cloud drive is separate. So computation paradigm has totally changed. So that's it. So there the Python helps. Why we are learning Python, probably understandable little bit about you. And there I think is the one great slide. You are already learning data structure and algorithm codes. Some people will ask whether chicken is earlier or egg. It's a typical question, whether chicken earlier, which it is faster, chicken or egg? Difficult. My belief is maybe chicken, then you might say what is egg. So same thing here in data structure, which one comes first, program or data structure? Program or data structure? So you all know that is not the answer. The answer is algorithm. Your algorithm will dictate which data structure you get. So if your algorithm is smart sort, there is a divide and conquer algorithm, you have a different data structure. If you work on a insertion sort, it's a different algorithm. So you can put your numbers in a linked list, or you put your number in an array. If you the smart sort, then you need an extra array for if you need a huge data, maybe 1 petabyte, 1 10^15 gigabyte is megabyte is 10^6, 10^9 gigabyte. So these are the huge data that is always generated right now. So this kind of data, if you want to sort it, you cannot sort it at a time within a memory. So you know the sorting algorithm are two types, mainly two types. One which you can sorting within your main memory. What is your memory? Maybe 32 GB at max, or maybe some of you have 8 GB machine, some have 16 GB. I personally have this machine with the 32 GB PC. So, but 32 GB is nothing if you want to sort it by petabyte. So I need a separate hard disk or SSD. I need to have petabyte, and I can make the availability of an array, and by divide and conquer, then whenever the size is at the 32, number of is 32, then we go change to insertion sort. You probably know smart sort is only good till it is in the size of 32. When the number of items comes to 32, we change to insertion. Coming back to this, the C has very limited data structure. So data structure, your C data structure has a very limited data structure. But in Python, you already know list is there. List is great, good thing. What is the difference between list and array? At least you have a different types of objects, you can pack them. Like if you have a bag, a big multi bag, whenever you go to a supermarket to buy things, you cannot have separate sizes of bag so that you can put in a size. It is not possible. It's a bag, you can put anything into it to supermarket and come. List is like this. You can add item like this. But whenever I make a bag, once I give a entered and make it a chained, locked it, I cannot add or delete something, then we call tuple. Agreed? It is a tuple. What is the difference between list and tuple? List is item can be anytime added, removed. It can be different types of items. It is not like C. So this is a great data structure. It will help you to good. But list, one limitation of list is that whenever you want to move a list or copy that list from in one place to another, then the tuple is much quicker. Tuple is much, much quicker. So that is the reason, like our my name. My example is my name, Somnath. That hopefully that name will not be changed in next 20 to 30 years or back 40 years. So this kind of, say, it is a, it's basically nothing like an array of characters or a list of characters, A-S-O-M-E. So wherever there is no change might be there, we'll put it in tuple. The tuple is much faster. It's like a string. In those who knows Java, they know string is also immutable. But C, there is no such concept of immutable. Okay, but this list is, our Python list is much more versatile than C list. Okay, so here I am discussing, but C doesn't have this, because whenever the C was developed in 1961, there's a very few limited resources, and only 64K machines are there, 8K machines. So they don't have the affordability of the memory. They say memory should be reused, but right now we have a huge memory. So we can say the memory, one memory portion, we make it immutable, like tuple is immutable in our Python. And we have a frozen set, another concept. Set is one concept, and frozen set. Frozen set cannot be changeable. That is the advantage. Okay, so data structure is would be more powerful in Python, because your data structure is becoming more powerful. You can put your data in a more intelligent way, so your program can be less powerful. That is the reason why you are going for a programming language where you can get lots of support from data structure. If you got a lots of support from data structure, it will take care of your more than half of your complexity of the program. So your program can be shorter, simpler, understandable, maintainable. So that is the great about the Python. But that is not there with C, definitely not C++, definitely not Java, because Java program is very verbose, is very talkative, that is not helpful to line the strings. Okay. Any question you can always tell. So this, I think, the revision of your data type in C, here also you have a primary data type, user defined. We have a lot of user defined in Python, and pointer is not there in Python. You know why pointer is not there. Pointer is too risky. No other language give pointer concept, not Java, no Python, because these are running on a virtual machine. There is no point to where it's going to, and it's very risky. We have the similar things in Python. Okay. See, well, let's forget. Now comes to the Python. Now Python, you first remember the Python, one is the immutable data type, that is changeable. This is like a C. It's like C. See, list is similar to C array. Okay, but list is more powerful. Dictionary, changeable. C doesn't have dictionary. It is a content addressable memory. You give a key, a value will be automatically come. It is immutable. Sets, you already know sets. What is the difference between set and list? Set, you know, is a mathematical set. No number can be duplicated, and there will be no order. Okay, A, B, C, B, A, C, C, A, B is the same, but at least A, B, C is different than B, A, C. You all know the order matters. And then the another, whenever the set, I can make it a frozen set, then the set can be immutable. Then it can be, it cannot be changed. That immutable things, all these things are necessary for a first data item in dictionary, I have told. The dictionary is a combination of two items. Left hand side should be an immutable data type. It may be number, it can be strings, it may be tuples, and maybe frozen set. Okay, all four items can be left hand value, and right hand value anything, any matters. So that is a great advantage of Python. I think here also we can see code data type. You have another is a none. None is undeclared kind of thing. Sequence is one great thing, because it comes in a sequence. That will be sets, I already discussed. Mapping, I have not yet discussed, but example is dictionary. Sequence has strings. Strings is immutable, I have told. Tuple is immutable. List is mutable. So various way you can see. Number, integer, that is a great integer. You can have infinite precision. Okay. It is no limitation. As the limitation of your hardware. Floating point, same thing. Complex number, not available in C. Boolean, also not available in C. You have to make Boolean concept by 0, 1, like this. Any question you can always. Data types, so little bit of programming we just practice. How much time is there? Oh, lots of time is there. So, code data type. So these are the code data type. You can always, it is available, this function. The sequence is not there in C. Number only, float and integer is there. Not complex data available in C. So we can make more data type. It is easier. Like these are examples, like you cannot, this is a greeting, it is a strings. This you cannot slice it. So we cannot slice it. I'll show you an example. Whenever I'll show the example, I'll show. X is a foil, integer. It is a string. Automatically, you can always, you know all these things. How to, you just give it type. You just say type of this thing, it will automatically come, whether it's integer, whether string, whether list. You can always type it. And how to see it's a list? Is opening third bracket and left third bracket. Nobody, whenever you declare a list, you don't have to declare a list by list. You just initialize list with the opening third bracket, ending third bracket with items there. It is a list. It is a, yeah, it's a first bracket, and here is the first bracket. That is a tuple that you cannot change the items. It's a opening second bracket, closing second bracket. It's two things can be possible. It can be a set or it can be a dictionary. If it's a dictionary, then it will be a pairs of items. Okay. I am telling you, this mutability concept is Java is there. Those who know Java, they know the immutable thing is there. Immutable things that in the whenever in the your program is running, you cannot change. Like string is not changed, and in Java that is called string buffer that can be changed. That's kind of an array. The advantage is immutable thing is much faster. Like here, left hand side you say tuple, frozen set, string. They are not numbers. They are not changes. Methods we generally call functions in object-oriented programming. We call them methods. And another great advantage of Python is other than object-oriented programming. I'll little bit touch on object-oriented programming. Whenever we generally we think of that we are all basically objects, and there's a class, a teacher class. I am a instantiation of teacher class. Devashish are also instantiation of teacher class, and teacher class is teaching and the students. Students come from the student class, and we are passing the messages. I am communicating with you, and with your innate understanding capability, you are understanding, or you can ask the question. This call is a method. I am giving a method, and the method is implemented differently. If say Simran doesn't know Python earlier, so she will look up a more detailed, and somebody else, say I just Sichita, know little bit of Python, maybe she look up in a different way. So it depends the method implementation, but someday they will convert, definitely convert. So that's it. Usability, all these things are a bit clear. Same thing, I just want to tell you dictionary. I have told you dictionary is opening second bracket, closing second brackets, and this is a key, and immutable, and this is a value. It can be mutable, it can be immutable. So list cannot be a key value. There's a typical question can be asked, list because they mean immutable. Age is a non-immutable, this is string. But here it is also immutable. So this is a pair, which can be anything. And another great thing about dictionary, may contains dictionary. That's a great thing. A set is immutable collection like this. I have told you is a second bracket. Tuple is like this. Nobody is a tuple if you can understand this. Okay, so that's great thing. List tuple we already covered. I have already covered in my earlier classes. Just this is a concept of a set. They said you can pass the list also. Here, it's the same thing almost. This is a set. You can add item to a set. It's a method is available. Add, remove. These are all methods. These are methods are available. This is one slide you can. This is a dictionary. How do you know dictionary? Not by this. This dict means doesn't mean dictionary. This opening second bracket and this closing second bracket and the existence of colon and a comma, this shows is a dictionary. Okay. So we just document it is pi underscore dict to easy readability. This is a key value, key, and this is a key. But remember, the key cannot be duplicated. I cannot have more than one key, but I can have another entry 3:apple. I can have 3. This value can be repeated, but this key value cannot be repeated. That's a great thing. We need this kind of dictionary anywhere, like our own English dictionary. But in our English dictionary different, then one particular key may have multiple values. Here it's not there. Make it simpler. Now one key can only one value, not multiple values. But this value can be repeated to another key. I hope. Okay, so that's it. Okay, so this slide may be a little bit difficult to view, but it will be day by day, it will be clearer. Our Python comes in here. Python, it is a dynamic. Why I call it dynamic? First, start with C. C is a static. Okay, it's a static. The concept of weak, I am telling you, C, C++. So you have to declare it earlier, the variable, and this is a static. And another is weak, I'll define it later. And what is strong? Python is dynamic. By dynamic means you don't have to declare earlier that whether it is integer or floating point number or string, it can change anytime. It change on its value. Whenever you put it in a different variable, it will take its shape. It's like a liquid kind of thing. It's a dynamic, but there's a risky part of it. In fact, that portion of Python, a risky part of it, that you may mistakenly take it as a programmer, mistake, put different thing, it behave differently. So that is one problem with Python. That is, C is not there. So that a Python dynamic, but one, and strong. This concept, keep it hold. This is the basic thing. So more or less, Python, this is Ruby, is another popular language, open source, freeware. In fact, another language, Go. So this kind of dynamic language is very essential for the programming on internet. It is strongly typed. Now a little bit of programming will go. Okay. This is a standard command so that for each, this is the advantage of using Google Colab. Whenever you are running Python, it will give you how much time it requires to run, so that you can make your program much smarter. So forget about it. This is not in the basic Python. This is PIP. It's a Python in PIP, the different installation mode in the Google Colab. And you can extend this auto time. I'll do it later. So I just, you have, this is very important. In Google Colab, you want to check it, which version is running. That is exclamation mark Python minus minus version. 99% Python command, it runs on your Python also. This is not only Google Colab command, this is which version it is running, because you know Python has two main versions. One is Python 2.0, another is Python 3.0. So right now, all our classes, we are going for Python 3, Python 3.6, 7, 9, 8, 9. More or less, these are minor version, but there's a lot of difference between Python 2 and Python 3. There are a lot of industrial codes is running on Python 2, so it is still not deprecated. So we should check which Python we are. Okay, so this is great. Now, if you want to run the operating system command within your Python, then you should import this command, import OS. Okay, just see. If you do not understand anything, please tell. See, it is already import OS, and it will give the which is the current path we are and how many files are there. Like here, your Unix, you always know the command is ls, and minus a means lh, hidden file, l is long format, a means all. So this is the standard command you are using in your Unix also. Ls, list the files in Unix, in Ubuntu or in your Linux, minus is option, A for all, L for long, H for hidden files. So they are given the, these are the files, it is stored in our my Google Drive there, not in machine. The whole thing is running at the Google's machine, at my space. Nobody can share this space. This is it is running. So this is the command, import to S command. Okay, great. See now, right now, say, right, yes. So it is, see, why, what is the second bracket open? It is a set. So I want to add 5. No use adding 5 because already 5 is there. So it is coming there, but no error is coming. So it is there because already set, you cannot add a duplicate item to set. In a tuple, you can have. That is the difference between tuple and set. Say here, I want to call a random integer. I'll import a file like, you know, C, it is include, here it is a random, it is a import. So this is a random, it is already there in Python. You import random function, then this is a for group. You just remember the for group, no bracket, only semicolon here, and you have to give at least 1, 2, 3 or 4, preferably 4. So here we maintain the 4, and that should be consistent. So here we run. See, it is running. This is the random number. It is coming. So if I say change 5 to say 10, I can 10 here also. See the change. Interrupt. Then I run it again. Yeah, that will help you. So I just make it interrupt call. So here, you see the random numbers are coming. I am doing, they are all random number from 10 times, range is 10. So, very simple syntax from random, import random. It is, what is double star? Exponential, 3. So, 2 to the power 2, this is 3 to the power 1, 3, 2 to the power 3 is 8, 2 to the power 8 is 256. So, that is a 256. So, if we little change it here, make it a 4, I think then it will be great, bigger number. See, it is 65536. So that is, you remember, this is a double star, means is exponential. It is like this kind of command in BASIC also there. Here I am making a rounding. See, round value J, and it is 1, because round minus 0.5 again is a 0.5, here 0.5, 0.5, 0.5, 1. So this is the value is 1. That's it. There's one great thing about max. Automatically, you don't have to write a routine for max. So this is a tuple. I want to get the maximum value of this tuple. So that's it. Max t is, why it is coming? Yeah, 4. Max t is a 4. Okay. So I think this is a comment, don't confuse it, please. 9, this time it should go, 9 should come. So that is the utility. You can see is a false. You might ask why it is false. That's a typical thing. This is a 0.1 plus 0.1, it should be 0.3. But why it is giving false? You know, typical numerical solution in C and here, same for Python. This 0.1 representation is a floating point number. This floating point number may not be, generally 99% not equal. So this should not be used. Double equal means if I say 1 and 1, then it will be okay. If 1, hopefully. I am giving all integers. Here also the problem with the machine, because we should not, here it show you, don't use this double equal to sign whether you are not 100% sure. There it is not there, I am making a mistake. Yeah, true. So because the perfect integer 1 and 2, the perfect integer make a perfect 3 and it is equals to 3. But if it is a 1.0, let's try another 1.0, floating point 2.0, it might give false. It is also true. So that's okay. But if I give the earlier version, that is a floating point number, it is better to avoid this kind of equality. Here I am the first now the object oriented program. What is object? You have to create a class, like I am create a class vehicle. Okay, the Python is a vehicle. This is not available in C, but it is available in C++. So C, it is a class definition. It's a type of variable. I'll just put the variable, and this is a constructor. Those who knows about Java, they know constructor. Constructor is called only once when the object is created. Object of that class type, automatically I have already given an example, like teacher is a class type, abstract class type, and I am SRC is a object of teacher class. Whenever I am created in back in 1960s old time, then I have some one head, two hands like this. So this constructor time this. The constructor in the Java, the constructor and the class name is the same, but in Python that is a function name, double underscore init double underscore, and the vehicle type. So this is the constructor, this will be called, and print vehicle is a vehicle type. Okay, this is a constructor. I am creating another class car, which mother class is vehicles. So what is the advantage of object oriented programming? You create a basic class and then you create a subclass. General characteristics like teacher and student, we are all humans. So I can create a main class, basic class type vehicles. I am creating another subclass with a parent class vehicle, and this is the constructor again underscore init self, vehicle is init car. So drive. So this is the print subclass car vehicle. So I just run this code, so it is coming only true, because it is a, yes, car is a type of vehicles, otherwise it will not give true. So in computer science, most of the logarithm you used base would be 2, not like in your physics class your base is E or 10. Here most of the class, you know, whenever you the complexity analysis in quicksort and all, everywhere whatever you see n log n, that log n is to the base 2. So how it is good to in Python you can do it, you have to just from math, this is the package, import log 2, then use the probability of event 0.5, calculate information for event. I'll explain what is information of event in machine learning. It is there, it will automatically give like information if it's a full bit, because if the probability the half, the information, if the probability 1, information will be 0. So this thing I'll clear it in next class. So what we have learned today, basic Python and various style, least difference between least, Python, tuple, dictionary, command wise. Then we have started how to give command to OS from Google Colab, that I have explained. And then I have explained just started with the object.